Dear students, today I am going to teach you the first poem in English called Grandma Climbs a Tree, which is written by Ruskin Bond. Before going to know about the poem, let us first know about the poet Ruskin Bond. Ruskin Bond was born in Kasauli in 1934. Ruskin Bond now lives in Missouri. He wrote his first novel, The Room on the Roof, when he was 17, and has written more than 30 books for children. Grandma Climbs a Tree shows Bond's great ability to enjoy unusual events and actions. In his autobiography, Scenes from a Writer's Life, Bond talks about his Calcutta granny as a strange person who sat alone in the evenings playing patience a card. So children, this is the small introduction of about the poet Ruskin Bond. Now I am going to read the poem. It's a very lengthy poem. Listen to me carefully and try to understand what I am reading. Okay, children, now I am going to read the poem. My grandmother was a genius. You would like to know why? Because she could climb trees, spreading or high. She would be up there, branches in a trice. And mind you, when last she climbed a tree, she was 62. Ever since childhood, she had had this gift for being happier in a tree than in a lift. And though, as years went by, she would be told that climbing trees should stop when one grew old, and that growing old should be gone about gracefully, she would laugh and say, "Well, I will grow gracefully. I can do it better." And we had to agree, for in all the garden there wasn't a tree. She hadn't been up at one time or another, having learned to climb from a loving brother when she was 6, but it was feared by all that one day she would have a terrible fall. The outcome was different while we were in town. She climbed a tree and could not come down. After the rescue, the doctor took Granny's temperature and said, "I strongly recommend a quite weak in bed." We sighed with relief and tucked her up well. Poor Granny, for her it was like a brief season in hell. Confined to her bedroom, while every breeze whispered of summer and dancing leaves. But she had held her peace till she felt stronger. Then she sat up and said, "I will lie here no longer." And she called for my father and told him, undaunted, that a house in a treetop was what she now wanted. My dad knew his duties. He said, "That's all right. You will have what you want, dear. I'll start work tonight." With my expert assistance, he soon finished the core, made her a tree house with windows and a door. So Granny moved up, and now every day I climb to her room with glasses and tray. She sits there in state and drinks sherry with me, upholding her right to reside in a tree. This poem is penned by a renowned short story writer for children, Ruskin Bond. Here, the poet, the grandson, vividly explains the hilarious incident involving in his old grandmother. He pays a tribute to her indefatigable spirit. She is highly enthusiastic and holds dogmatic views and irreversible thoughts. Now I am going to read the poem. First stanza, listen to me carefully. My grandmother was a genius. You would like to know why? Because she could climb trees spreading or high. She would be up their branches in a trice. And mind you, when last she climbed a tree, she was 62. Ever since childhood, she had had this gift for being happier in a tree than in a lift. In the first stanza, we can see that the poet called his grandmother genius because she could climb a tree, whether it was broad or tall. She was skillful and she could climb it very quickly. She could climb tree tirelessly even at the age of 62. She had this gift and enjoying it, though it was unusual. She did it with her ease and expertise day and repeatedly. She was very calculative in her endeavor and pleased herself immensely. Ash. She had desire of climbing a tree even at that age. Therefore, the poet called his grandmother a genius. Second stanza. And though, as years went by, she would be told that climbing trees should stop when one grew old, and that growing old should be gone about gracefully. She would laugh and say, "Well, I will grow disgracefully. I can do it better." And when we had to agree, for in all that garden, there wasn't a tree. In the second stanza, the poet explained that grandmother was unperturbed to the endurance and the obstacles of any kind. She was utterly stubborn when she was told that in old age one should be graceful and not indulge in such dangerous acrobat. She would reply that she would be proud to be disgraceful than to abandon her very habitual expertise. This shows that grandmother had great desire to climb the trees. In the garden of the poet's house, grandmother climbed all the trees. Grandmother did not leave not even one tree without climbing. So this is what the grandmother's desire. Third stanza. She hadn't been up at one time or another. Having learned to climb from a loving brother when she was 6, but it was feared by all that one day she would have a terrible fall. The outcome was different. While we were in town, she climbed a tree and could not come down. In the third stanza, we can see that she had learnt climbing the trees from her loving brother when she was 6. The poet and his family feared that one day she would have a terrible fall. But the most unexpected happened. She could not climb down a tree and held there until she felt sick. Fourth stanza. After the rescue, the doctor took Granny's temperature and said, "I strongly recommend a quiet week in bed." We sighed with relief and tucked her up well. Poor Granny, for her, it was like a brief season in hell. Confined to her bedroom, while every breeze whispered of summer and dancing leaves. In the fourth stanza, we can see that she was rescued and the doctor advised the granny 1 week bed rest. That period appeared like stay in hell, and she did not want to be alone on the bed. She did not want to be alone in the room. She wanted to come out of the room. She wanted to enjoy every moment of her life by coming out of the room, climbing the trees, and enjoying the fantastic fine weather. Outside the house, there was fine weather. The summer whispered the leaves of the trees in the garden were dancing due to the breeze. So she wanted to enjoy all these things, but she never liked to be alone on bed. She did not like to be confined to bed. So she wanted to come out of the house to climb the trees. Fifth paragraph. But she had held her peace till she felt stronger. Then she sat up and said, "I will lie here no longer." And she called for my father and told him, undaunted, that a house in a treetop was what she now wanted. "My dad knew his duties," he said. "That's all right. You will have what you want, dear. I'll start work tonight." In the fifth stanza, we can see that being alone in the room, confined to bed, was not liked by grandmother. She could not resist her temptations. Once she improved her health, she could not stop her spirit of climbing trees. Therefore, she demanded for a tree top house. The poet's father, who knew his duties, with the technical help of the poet, built a house on the tree top to satisfy her unusual demand. The last stanza. "With my expert assistance, he soon finished the code, made her a tree house with windows and a door. So Granny moved up, and now every day I climb to her room with glasses and tray. She sits there in state and drinks sherry with me, upholding a right to reside in a tree." In the last stanza, we can see that in order to satisfy the demand of the poet's grandmother, the poet's father built a house on the tree top with the assistance of the poet. And he was able to complete that work within no time. The house on the top of the tree had windows and a door. After some time, the granny moved up to the house on the treetop. Now, every day, the poet used to carry sherry, which enjoyed by the granny, upright the tree house. So every day she was enjoying the time there on the treetop. In this poem, Grandma climbs a tree. The poet carries the message to the young generation that honoring the wishes of the old, even if it appears illogical and stupid, must be satisfied. And the duty of young is to show them gratitude and unconditional love. The noblest sacrifice of the elders should be reciprocated by gratitude, which is the noblest virtue. The old generation should be kept in happy mood as they long for care, love, and affection. The poet and his father exhibited themselves as an epitome of dutifulness to elders. There is a saying, old habits die hard. So this saying is more suitable to this poem known as Grandma Climbs a Tree. Now let us know the meanings for some of the difficult words. First one, in a trice. In a trice means very quickly. Second one, outcome. What actually happened? Third one, undaunted. Without hesitation. Fourth one, disgraceful. Meaning of the word is disrespect. Next one, core. Core means task. Next one, sherry. Sherry means yellow or brown colored wine. Next one, upholding. Making clear to the world. So these are the some of the meanings for difficult words that we can see in this poem. In this poem, there are some lines which are related to figure of speech. First one, it was like a brief season. Here, the figure of speech is simile. Second one, while every breeze whispered of summer and dancing leaves. Here, the figure of speech is personification. Okay, children, this is all about the poem Grandma Climbs a Tree, written by Ruskin Bond. Thanks. Thanks a lot.